NC.
Hi all and welcome at my channel. On this video here I'm going to show you how you can take out easily a BIOS chip from any motherboard. So that means I will show you how to remove a BIOS chip from any motherboard. This is now a motherboard from a notebook, but this works also for, we can say, bigger motherboards from, we can say, bigger computers or whatever. I will show you also two methods how you can take it out. So you can take out such BIOS chips with, we can say, a special heat gun, like I got one like this here, and you can set the temperatures, and you got here also some, we can say, some adapters where you can choose the adapters which you need to we can say to heat it up. And if you don't have some special heat gun like me, you can also use we can say just a normal heat gun. You can buy it everywhere, and I will also later tell you the temperatures, but you need to know that not all the heat guns are the same. So I got here a heat gun from Einhell, and here the temperatures that it shows on the display, they are really, very nice. But sometimes you will maybe be unlucky when you got you a very cheap heat gun. That can be that when it's here written 350 or 380 degrees, that this heat gun maybe just brings about 240 degrees, okay? So it's really important that your heat gun has, we can say, real temperatures just like this one here, because this temperatures that it shows here is really the right temperatures. The other thing is also what you need to know: if you use we can say hot air or a heat gun, you should set the ventilator speed on the lowest, okay? So if you just make it on, you just should really set the lowest fan speed, really so low as you can. Alright, the other thing that I will also show you is you can also take out a BIOS chip with a solder station, a soldering station, just like with this solder iron or whatever it calls in English. For the newcomers on my channel, sorry for my English, I'm not the best, but I'm trying my best so that everyone can understand something. Alright, I will now just also explain you where we can say to find, or how you can see which one is the BIOS chip. So you got here lots of chips like you can see, and on the other side you have also a lot of chips. Okay, now I will just show you quickly if you got a problem with your USB, or if you got a problem with your BIOS chip and you need to take it out to whatever, maybe you need to flash it like we can say with this USB programmer here, then you will need to take this BIOS chip out. Okay, like you can see here, we got here, we can say this chip, and it has on every side, we can see four legs. So that means that you can see already on the top, on the left side here, you also can see there is some color. So someone or the manufacturer has done here, we can say here with some color, a point, or we can say a dot, that you know also how to place the chip, or sometimes just that you know that this is a BIOS chip. Okay, the other thing that is also important is, like I have try to explain you with this now, every BIOS chip has, we can say, a symbol. I will now try to show you this. You got here on the, let's put it down like this, like that. You got here on the left side down, you got a small circle. Okay, so you can see here the manufacturer from the chip itself, Wait, this may be too much of zoom. I need to take care. And there, left, you got here. You see here? You got here a circle. And this circle, when you solder it back together, when you want to solder this BIOS chip back to the motherboard, it needs to be down on the left side here, okay? If you put this circle over there or here or whatever, you will make, we can say, a short circuit maybe, and the BIOS chip will be destroyed. So that's why just take care that this symbol here is always on the same position as you have taken it out. Okay, I think I have nothing more to say about that. For first, I want to show you how you can get easily, we can say, a BIOS chip out. You can, like I told, use hot air, or you can use a soldering station just like with this stuff here. Other thing that is also great is if you got some flux, that would be great, because with flux it makes it easier to take the BIOS chip out. If you don't have some flux at home, you can also just take some solder. Wait, I need to search it. Oh, here, I got it. So, just take some solder and just sold, we can say, all the legs, all the pins from, we can say, the BIOS chip. Just resold them quickly. So that means you go here, you just solder it here, and you do some soldering here, here, and here, and all over the pins, and then it will be better for you to take it out, because sometimes if the motherboard is very old, the soldering contacts, they are really hard. So for now I have just put my camera to another place so that I will be able here to heat, we can say, this BIOS chip up, and we will heat it up at 340 till 380 degrees. And if you set 380 degrees, of course this gets faster and it will be also easier for you to take it out. But as you set it on 380 degrees, you need also take care that you don't stay, we can say, here too long. Otherwise you will of course burn all the PCB or the motherboard. So I'm gonna here just go with this heat gun without adapter, because some people's at home doesn't have some special equipments, and that's why I'm gonna show you how you can do that easily just with a heat gun, just like I have here. And I will now just zoom back a bit that you really can see. I go here about 300, let's do 300, let's do, yeah, 360 degrees should be enough. And before I forget, if you are not sure at which temperature your heat gun is really working, then you can just, we can say, turn on your heat gun, and then you just hold, we can say, some soldering in the front of the heat gun, and when you see it gets melt, then we can say you got nearly the best temperatures. So now let's just check it out. Set the fan speed at lowest, like I told. And this is now here 300 degrees. We will go for 360, like I told. And now you can do a quick test and see if the soldering begins to melt, and like you can see, it works, okay? So, wait, because I need to zoom or focus. You can see it's, yeah, working. Alright, so that means you can do it like that if you don't know if your heat gun brings really the real temps or not. And some people doesn't have at home a heat gun with a, we can say, temperature display. So that's why you should do it like that, so that you know when the soldering wire begins to melt. Alright, now just let it heat it up, like I told you. I will go here over there. And you should also get something like this here. If not, You just can move it away the chip, but take care that you don't touch any other SMDs or whatever, because you could remove other parts and that would be bad. Okay, so that's why just heat it up, and if you got something like that, then you can just take it away, or you just take a screw drill and you push it to the left side. But take care, like I told, because you could remove some other parts and that will be not great. Alright, I will go now for 360 degrees and let's see that. ...250, 320, 360. Okay, I don't know if you can see that. I got here already 360 degrees. I will now begin and then you can see how this works. So here we go. And if you don't want to heat up your motherboard so long time, then really just set it at 380 degrees and of course you are faster and then you can take it out also faster and you don't need to heat it up that long. Alright, we can say this was now just to show you how you can get the BIOS chip easily without problems out, and later if you want to solder it back again with a heat gun, you just need to be also sure, like I told, that you just take care where the symbol was, and then you can go over here and you just place it really just perfectly back. You need to take care that all the pins are really over the soldering places, and then if you have set it really right, you can begin, we can say, to heat it up again. But first, yeah, you need really to take care how you place the chip, because this is the most important if you work here with hot air. So I will now just try my best here. Okay, this should be good. I see it already. I can see that all the pins are sitting over the soldering contacts. If you got some flux, it's okay. You can add here some flux because it will help you to solder. So you can go here and then you just add here some flux and this will help you to solder back the BIOS chip. But I will now just do it without flux because a lot of people just doesn't have it at home. And that's why I will just show you that this is just possible also without flux, but it's better you use flux because the contacts, the soldering contacts will of course get better and it will, yeah, it will of course hold longer. Also not forget is when you want to solder it back, you should go with your heat gun from, we can say about, yeah, 20 centimeters. You should go down and down and down, and that you really need to do slowly, otherwise if you go like that the chip will fly away. Okay, so just take care that the air comes directly from up and then you go deeper and deeper inside. Okay, or let's say you go really slowly down and take care that you don't move too much with your hands, because if you just shake too much the chip will really fly away, because yeah, if your heat gun has not that low fan speed, the chip will really fly away, and that's why I tell you, you will need to do that like I told you, begin from up and go down and down, easily down for, yeah, about maximal, or I say, yeah, about 1 minute should be really enough, okay? But not too much, because you don't need, or let's say you need to take care that you don't heat up the motherboard too much, okay? I will now begin, and I will just let it like that, because that you can see, sorry, I need to move my tripod, that you can see that I'm really doing it like that. I will now go for 380 degrees, because it's got, yeah, it works of course a bit faster, and I don't need to hold the hot air gun so much time on the motherboard. Alright, I will now begin, like I told you, from up about 20 centimeters. Just heat up the chip a bit so that the chip get in place. And then it just goes slowly and slowly down till you see that the soldering is beginning to work, and then the chip will get soldered from alone. I will now try to zoom a bit in. Okay, it's finished. The chip is soldered back. I don't know if you was able to see that, but if you do that yourself, you really can see how the solder will begin to work, and then it will really get, we can say, soldered back. So, and wait. Normally you need to wait about, let's say, 1 2 minutes. Yeah, it's okay. Now it's fixed it back like it should be, and I will not just stand up. I will not put the heat gun away. Then I will try to show you how this should look. So here we go. You can see all the 4 feet, or all the 4 pins from the BIOS chip, is, we can say, solder it back. And here it's a bit hard to see because I can't, but it's okay, you see it already just perfectly. And yeah, it's hard for me to zoom more, because as more as I zoom, as more this could be bad for the video. All right, now I'm just gonna show you also how you can solder, or we can say remove, the BIOS chip just with a, yeah, soldering station. And for that you will need to know that you need to solder, we can say, all the 4 chips, or all the, sorry, to solder all the 4 pins on this side together, and you need also to solder all the 4 pins on the other side together, just so you will be able to get this BIOS chip out. Because if you don't have special equipment, you will need really to work like that. So, but now I'm gonna just place it like here, otherwise this will be all difficult for me to record all. So I'm gonna zoom in again, and now I will do that with you together. And we will do the option number 2. We will now take out the BIOS chip without, without a heat gun. We will just do it with a soldering station. So here we go. For first, like I told, you just go over there. Take care at other parts, like I told. And now just add here everywhere, we can say, on the BIOS chip, just add here really enough solder, like here, okay? Now you can see I have soldered all the four contacts together, which it makes us later possible to get this chip out, because you don't need to solder every pin or every feed from this BIOS chip, and that's why you will never be able to get it out with a soldering iron just like I got, if you don't do it like that, because you will need really ears to take the chip out, and that's why I tell you, you will need to do it like that. So, yeah, and I will now try to solder over here, just that you all be able to see what I'm doing. And again, just here, putting everywhere, we can say here, the soldering over all the four contacts, okay? Okay, and don't be afraid, you will not destroy anything, because I have made this a lot of times. The BIOS chip, as long as it gets no energy, will not get damaged. Because some people will now come on my channel and say, well, you cannot do that like this and whatever. But I have tested a lot of times and this works just perfectly. Now, I don't know how I will do that for the video. But I need to hold it some kind of on the other side, otherwise I will not be able to. You will now need to be fast. You will now to hit. You will now need to go here with your soldering iron, and you will need, we can say, to solder on the left side, solder on the right side, solder on the left side, and you do that really, we can say, so fast that you can move it. We can say move the chip slowly as you do that away. I will not try to show you that, okay, it's already working. Here we go. So, I still also prefer, of course, to do that with a heat gun. But like you can see, now we got our chip out, and now we will need just to clean. I will put the chip on the table, that you can see that here. Now you just need to clean this all, and that's why it's better when you have flux. So I will not just demonstrate you how easy you can get all this out, all the rest of the, we can say, soldering with flux, and just that you can see how easy this gets off, okay? Here we go. Now you can see all the contacts are, we can say, clean. Later you can clean it better, but you don't need. Now the same goes also if you have no flux, that could be a bit, we can say, difficult for you to get this soldering stuff here out, but should be also no problem. But if it's a problem, then you just take some new soldering wire, because in the soldering wire you also have flux inside, okay? And that's why you do not do that, please, if the solder gets old, we can say, then it will lose the flux. And that's why you should do that always with some flux. And if you don't have any flux, just like me at home, like this one here, then just take some new soldering wire, because every soldering wire has also flux inside. So when you see, you got here lots of solder, you see that? Okay, then you just go here with a solder, with a new soldering wire, and you see it gets easily out without problem, because it gets flux, and then you will be able to clean all the contacts without problem. So I will put this away. The next step for me is now to show you how to clean, we can say, the USB chip. And here we go. You go here, you take it, we can say, in your hand, yeah. Or you just have some stuff like this here again, but you can take it in your hand, you will not burn your fingers. You just need to take care that you go over here, and then you just soldering, or you go here with the soldering iron, and then you just push it to the front, okay? So just touch it here, and then you push it to the front, okay? This is really just easy. I will not try to show you this again. Hope the focus is right. Here again, wait. Okay. So here we got, let's say, two contacts together. This should be, of course, not like that. The chip gets now very hot because I'm soldering on there. But my fingers has touched already a lot of stuff. So yeah, now you can see that the solder, we can say, is still very great. That's why I need to place it here down, so it will be together again, just like now, okay? Because when the solder is new, it gets, of course, easier out. And that's why if we can say the solder loses flux, then it will be harder to get it off. But like I told, if you just want to clean it, wait, so I need to hold it better, just go over here with new solder wire, we can say, you see, it, this, the smoke means there is now enough of flux, and then you just go here, and you see, you just pull it to the front, here, look, really nice, you see, it should look like that. It's hot like hell, but like I told, I made this already 1,000 times. Okay, now, like I told, clean your workplace, of course. Now we're gonna solder it back together. And this is also very easy. I will show you, we can say, how easy this can be. Don't forget, of course, like I told you, the position from, we can say, the symbol. Now on this side you can also see that you got here a white line, and that's why they have painted, we can say, white here, that you know that this needs to be on this side, okay? Because so it will not work, you see that? Wait, here we go. Like that, this will not work because the contacts are, of course, wrong. And when the contacts are wrong, the chip gets hot and it will really be destroyed, because it will have a short circuit. Alright, for the, we can say, for the pros, for the special people, if you want to clean these contacts, I don't know where I have it right now, but I'm gonna try to search it. Because I got here some desolder wire, it calls like that, but I'm not sure if I will find it right now, because I was here cleaning my table and I see I cannot find it right now. That doesn't matter at all, because yeah, I got here some of them. Okay, I got here, like you can see, lots of this, we can say, desolder wire or whatever it calls. With this stuff here, you can clean, we can say, the most of the old, we can say, solder. For that, you also, of course, go here with some flux. This is not just for the, we can say, for the professional peoples that want to see that. So if you got all at home, like me, all the parts, then now you can go here with this desolder wire, you see that, just go over here and just clean it, and then this gets really new. So just move it away, and you can see how easy this gets if you got, like I told, some flux and desolder wire. I hope it calls like that. If not, sorry again that I don't know all in English, but I'm trying always to do that in English so the most people will understand something. If you want to clean all these contacts, then you can go here. If you don't have special stuff just like me, I got here some special stuff like this here, SMD Reworks fluid. If you don't have this stuff, then you can also use some contact spray. You can buy this everywhere, and then you just take the contact spray, then you just take something like this here, okay? You go over there, see, just a bit, and then you can just clean this easily out, look. And you will not damage anything because this is just contact spray. And this will never ever damage anything. It will just make it better. So, look. It gets really, really clean. And you can buy contact spray everywhere. So at last you can go here. We can say with a bit of toilet paper if you like. But this is just if you want that it looks nice. So if you want that it looks nice, then you can do it just like me here. And look, this looks just like new. Maybe better than new, because sometimes the manufacturers doesn't do that so good. And mostly they let some rests of flux. So I will now try to show you this, how clean this looks. Okay. And the rest on the side and whatever here, you can also clean all with this contact spray. But now I have just cleaned this part here, this place, I have just now cleaned it, and look how it looks. Just like new. Alright, now I go and I will begin to solder back the BIOS chip, otherwise this video will take too long. So now let's go again here. You can, like I told, do it all with your hands, or you just go here over that, take this like I have here now, and then it works also just perfectly. So I recommend you that you just solder, we can say, always first just one contact. That means just solder here, left down, you just solder this contact here on the left side down, okay? Just solder always just first 1 feet or one contact, one pin, so that you later can, we can say, adjust the position if you maybe have soldered wrong. Okay? So now I'm gonna here just make the first solder point. Like I told, you can just begin to solder one contact. Do not solder or try to solder all the contacts together at one time. Let me see if you can see that great. Yeah, it's okay. So now I will just solder, we can say, one contact. I will go for this one here and finish. Okay, so now you can see I have just soldered it. I have just soldered this contact there where the paint is. Up on the right side I have soldered this first contact, this first pin. Okay, up on the right side. Now I'm gonna solder the contact down on the left side. So here is the chip and I need to focus. Alright, now I go here. Now you can also just adjust the chip if it's wrong for you, or if you have soldered it, we can say bad, then now you can just move it a bit, you see? Because we have just soldered one contact, and that's why I told you guys, just solder one contact, then you are free and you can set it how you like. Okay, now I'm gonna here begin, we can say, with a second contact, and here we go, okay? And I have soldered it diagonal, like you can see. I have soldered it, the very first contact, up on the very right side, and then I have soldered it also the very first contact on the left side down, okay? Here we go. And then you now can go over all the contacts, and of course now you need to solder really great, and you need also to take care that you don't solder any other contact together. If you now solder two contacts together like I have done it now for purpose, you can also take both contacts out like I showed you like I have shown you before. Just get here some new solder and then you just move it away. Wait, got not too much solder on it. And move it away. See? Now you got here again two contacts which are together. Do the same till it gets off. I just show you now this all with soldering wire, because with, we can say, flux, this will be much more easier. But I show you this all now just with just the soldering wire. Here we go. Okay, now the contacts are, we can say, again, separated and not together. You need to take care that you don't solder any contacts together. It must just be all like it was before, just all the same. So now we will go to this side. Let me see where I am here. Focus is okay again, but this is not just bad for me to solder, because I need it not like that. Yeah, I will try now to solder it just here, and so that you guys can still see all. Here we go. And here we go. Looks good. All right. This was now, we can say, a quick tutorial how you can solder the chip back. And of course I need to say, if you know, really, if you really know that you need to do that, so go and get you some flux, okay? Just buy it on eBay or whatever. I will not just add you some flux that you can see how clean this later will look if you have some flux with you, okay? So just clean also always your soldering iron, okay? When you clean it, of course, you will be able to solder really, really clean. So I'm going now and I will try to show you this, how beautiful it looks when you got some flux with you. Need to see where this, here this, for you guys can see. Alright. So, now I can do it off, like I have already told you, you cannot just here put some contact spray, and then you now can clean this all. If it needs to look, we can say like new, then you will need some SMD rework flux. Or like I told, you will need some contact spray. Yeah, then you will be able to clean this really sometimes better as new. So guys, I'm finished. I will now just show you how clean this looks. And I hope you are happy with my work. Wait. Because we got too much of zoom here. I need to zoom back a bit. And here we go now. Now I will be able to zoom and look at this. Okay. My smartphone just doesn't like too much zoom. You can see this side now, just like new. I will now turn to the other side, because this side is a bit, yeah, bad to record, because I need to hold it like that. But here, I'm gonna be able to show you this, yes. lots of zoom, but you can see it looks like new. Okay guys, I hope you like this tutorial. This was just a quick tutorial, we can say, on how to remove some BIOS chips from notebooks or from any motherboards. And you can do that, like I told you, with some heat gun, and you can do it also with an iron station or soldering station if you know how to work. But now again, for you that you can see, here we go, just clean and perfect, like it should be if you work like me and see in the place to be. All right, see ya, peace, take care, thumbs up for my time and for this tutorial, and for the newcomers on my channel, sorry again my English, subscribe anywhere here down, yeah, it's here, just click on there, subscribe please, and a lot, some thumbs up for my work, and I wish you the best, and I wish all peoples that you will fix your problem now, and yeah, just stay tuned on my channel and take care. Bye bye. Peace.
NC. In the place to be. NC.